Jack closed the lid of the car and leisurely began to pack for home. He worked in a service station as a simple mechanic. After putting all the tools back in their place, Jack locked up the garage and drove home. On the way, he suddenly saw a young woman standing near the car, waving her hand in confusion. Jack stopped and got out of the car. The girl coquettishly said that the car stalled, she did not know what to do. The guy made an inspection, then took something out of the trunk of his car, put it in the car, and voila, the car started. The girl jumped up and down with joy and hugged the guy. Jack was embarrassed and told her it was just a temporary fix and she had to go to the repair shop tomorrow. And then he handed her his card. The girl promised to come over and quickly ran off to the car. Jack drove on too, and spent the entire evening thinking about the strange girl he had grown very fond of. The next day, it was like he was flying on wings. He literally had everything falling out of his hands, and colleagues even began to tease him if he fell in love. And closer to evening, she arrived. Long dark hair, brown eyes, and chiseled figure. Not a girl, but a dream. She politely said hello and waved to the young man. He decided not to charge her after helping her with the repair of her car. The girl was pleased and offered to drink coffee as her thanks. Her name was Carol and she worked in a cell phone network. She was ambitious and had a strong character. She had a lot to be proud of. She came to the company as a courier and rose to the position of senior manager. She always knew with whom to communicate, with whom not to communicate. She believed that everywhere there must be a benefit. For what reason Carol was interested in a simple guy who works as a car mechanic, it is difficult to say. Apparently, the chemistry of the attraction, which she could not understand. And she felt that she was attracted to this simple worker from their first meeting. And sitting with the guy in a cafe, Carol found herself thinking that she really cared about him, and immediately asked who he lived with. Jack was a little embarrassed to say that he grew up in an orphanage and had no relatives or a girlfriend. The next day they met again. They took a long walk through the evening city, ate ice cream, and chatted until almost morning. Then she disappeared. The boy wrote messages, but the girl did not answer. Carol understood that such an unexpected meeting literally changed everything in her life. She could no longer think of anyone but Jack. But what could he give her? Only love and affection, and she needed something more tangible. After a week, she couldn't take it anymore and decided to let it go. She got in her car and went to the car service where the guy worked. He cheered and kissed her, and Carol was touched by the treatment. She explained to Jack that she was afraid of becoming very attached to him, because she had already had her heart broken once. "But none of that matters, tomorrow is my birthday, I expect you to visit," the girl whispered the address and left. Jack immediately forgot the insult and was already anticipating their next meeting. The next day, everything was like in the movie, a huge teddy bear with a bow, a lot of champagne congratulations. Jack and Carol did not even have time to realize how they began to live together. The guy quickly understood that she was his one and only, the woman he had been waiting for years. A little time passed and Jack proposed to Carol. She said yes. A white dress, a beautiful wedding, and now they are a young couple. But the happiness of the family idyll was short-lived. A year passed and the couple began to have their first disagreements. Carol devoted herself to work. She was hardly ever at home, rarely did housework. Jack first reprimanded her, then they argued several times about everyday life. And so it went on for 2 more years. The man began to think about children. He wanted to hear children's laughter, see their baby's first steps, and imagine how their daughter or son would call them mom and dad. But Carol thought that it was not the right time to have children, because her boss had big plans for her, and she did not want to break everything by going on maternity leave. And then something happened that no one could even imagine. Jack was tracked down by an employee of a social project to find missing people. It turned out that Jack had a sister. A couple of years after he was placed in the orphanage, his mother got pregnant again and his sister came to the world. The girl has grown up and raised 3 children alone without a husband. By a tragic accident, she was hit by a car. An indifferent neighbor appealed to the fund to find possible relatives of the girl and the children were not sent to an orphanage. Jack was just dumbfounded, but pulled himself together and the next day he met the children, 2 boys and a girl from 2 to 6 years old. When he told everything to Carol, she was in amazement. How his sister had so many children at the age of 25, what did she think she was doing? Jack persuaded his wife that they would cope, especially as the children spend most of the day in the garden. But Carol was not happy and did not want her children to live with them. After a long talk, Jack managed to persuade his wife to take the children to her place. When all the formalities were settled, the children began to live with them. For a long time, Carol smothered her lips and did not speak to her husband. Over time, she began to stay at work more and more often, and somehow became distant. Money was constantly in short supply, because Jack now worked less, as he had to spend a lot of time with the children. Carol was irritated by the children and the constant problems with finances. After disappointing so much for 6 months, she packed her things and left them, leaving her husband a note with the words, "I'm sorry, but I can't take it anymore. This life is not for me. I'm leaving for someone else. Don't look for me." Jack was very nervous, but then he pulled himself together and thought of the children. After all, the children have no one but him. He realized that in order to feed the children, he needed to work more, so he found a nanny. It was a humble, simple girl named Susan. People didn't like hiring her because of a congenital lame, but Jack liked her warm and kind attitude toward the children. And she turned out to be a savior for Jack and the children. Not only did she take care of the children and help out around the house, but she was also patient with the man, listening to him attentively and giving him helpful advice. It was she who gave him the idea to open his own repair service. Jack had always worked for someone and had never thought about being a business owner before. But as it turned out, he did an excellent job as a business owner, and the service station began to bring in an impressive income. Over time, real love arose between Jack and Susan, which grew out of attention, care, and empathy. They got married and had a child together. And so Jack, Susan, and their four children lived as a big friendly family, where everyone loved and was loved. 10 years had passed. One day Jack was sitting in his office, analyzing reports, when suddenly the senior mechanic came in and said that they had a customer who was dissatisfied with the amount of repairs. The mechanic was followed by a woman, and when Jack looked at her, he was stunned. His ex-wife Carol was standing in front of him. She was modestly dressed and looked a bit burnt out. She was very surprised to see her ex-husband in the director's chair. And immediately forgetting what she came for, she suggested Jack to forget all the old insults and start all over again. Jack said nothing to her. He only shook his head in the negative and made it clear that the past was irreversible. Then he left her for a senior manager and left. And Carol bitterly regretted that she had left him then. It took a long time before Carol realized who she had lost. But that's life. A woman didn't appreciate what she had, and when she lost, she wept bitter tears. Dear friends, thank you very much for watching. Subscribe to our channel and like the video. We really need your support. Have a great day and see you again.